Vincent, I came here to present you our induction presentation. The topic of our presentation is the company which is named as Panasonic, which worked on so many products, electrical and electronics as well. But we are talking about new technologies, how the technology grow in the market, how the technology come down in the market. What is the reason behind that? So that's why we chosen this topic. I love this company. I have a refrigerator with me, the first refrigerator of Panasonic only. So the company in this particular smartphone segment, the technological advanced company, has failed in a particular smartphone segment. How that failed? So, next.
So as ma'am said, we both have a motivational speaker who we look up to as an inspiration, and he's the first batch alumni pass out of this college. He is Mr. Deepak Rai. I guess you all know about him. So you guys got it?
That's right. So here is the content.
This is the content we'll be going through. Now he'll be explaining about the launch and the products.
So the first point is launch and product. First thing first, as you know. So the company Panasonic started in Japan in 1980s, early 1980s. But it came to India in 2013 in July. In 6th of July, they launched their first phone, which is known as P51. And that time they have launched the three series, the P series, T series and Aluga series. The T series consists of basic model which have the price range of 3000 to 8000. It's for the medium range mobile, basic design and all. Along with that, there is a P series mobile which target average customers. And the third one is Aluga series, which targets a premium customer, but they launched it after so many years.
Now, moving on to the reasons of failure, we know this topic is a negative topic, but we should take it in a positive manner. You all know negativity leads to problems, and problems leads to?
That's exactly right. The first point is specification and the pricing, which the Panasonic has done. So the first point is, initially they price their mobile phones between 5000 to 14000. They target only the medium range and average range customers. They didn't target the premium customers, so they lost it there only. So they started with the mobile with a very basic design. In the Indian society, in the Indian market, people like little sluggish mobile design and all. So that is the reason the people, they designed a very basic design, the people didn't like that. How many of, I have a just little question here, how many of you have used, if you go for a shop to buy a mobile phone, so what the first thing which you see to buy a mobile phone, what the first specification which you see? So people are saying camera, that's right. So the Panasonic is also didn't go in cameras. They have a very low standard cameras which they are using it. Along with that, they have no standout feature. Like if Apple goes for a brand, Oppo goes for a camera, this doesn't have any standout feature in their mobile brands. Along with that, the battery is very low, battery backup is not there, and omission of headphone jack. They omitted the headphone jack in the first, they thought if they connect with the Bluetooth, the earphones, so that will be a great idea. But Indian people loves connectivity, so they lost.
So moving on to the next topic, it's like selection of wrong marketing partners. So when Panasonic started their production and their distribution ship, they had two partners. One was Jaina Marketing and Dixon Technologies. Jaina Marketing was the distributor, strategical distributors, marketers, and after sales support for them. This Jaina Marketing had almost 21K retail outlets and 85K of distributions and also 10K of service units. But then why did they fail? Still the sales came down, all those things happened. The reason being, if you see this graph, they started production in 2013. The launch in 2013. Till 15 it was going good. And then what happened is like suddenly Jaina Marketing started their own manufacturing of carbon mobiles. And what happened, from the shelves, Panasonic phones started to come down and carbon mobiles started to come up. So Panasonic was dropped out of the graph, and you can see from 15 the steady downfall of the revenue was generated. Okay, and the next one is like Dixon Technologies. What happened with Dixon Technologies, they are the manufacturing, assembly supporters for Panasonic in India. And they have a manufacturing unit in Noida. And because of the overflow of the production, what they did was like they shifted their manufacturing unit from Noida to Trichy. This also led to the lot of chaos between the company, as said by one of the person in Panasonic. Going to the wrong researcher distribution model. So you can see in 2017-18 it was going down. So what they decided, like, they will go with their own distribution model, and they dropped Jaina marketing. And what happened is, like, they changed the distribution model from 150 to 350, and retailers also was increased. And there was more employment, everything was there, but they didn't know that they had a very sales performance, very bad sales performance. And this again led to the downfall to 500 crores, the revenue.
Sorry to interrupt you guys, but we want an undivided attention here, because this topic is really important. If Panasonic comes in our company, so everyone who present here should know about what Panasonic works, so everyone should place in that company. So please pay attention here. So the after sales, poor after sales, they have the customer support. It's also one more major reason after the Panasonic smartphone segment failed. That the first reason is unavailability of spare parts. They don't have that spare parts in that account, in their customer service shops, so they can give the customers a fast and secure service. The second point is they have very poor trained staff. They don't have that Six Sigma in their company that time, and they have that's why they taken more time to troubleshoot the problems of any customers, right? And they have 126 customer service center in their whole India. But the thing is, the 126 service centers consist of all the products, electricals, electronics, everything they do in the same service center. They don't have any particular different segment for a smartphone. Now, as you can see, it's a Panasonic India product revenue, whole product, electrical, electronics and smartphone. So in the year of 17-18, the smartphone revenue is 1200 crores and the total revenue is 10,200 crores. And in the year of 18-19, it drastically fall down. The revenue which is left is only 500 crores, as he mentioned earlier, and the total revenue is 10,300 crores that time. So they have also focus shifted from smartphone segment to other segment. Anyone can tell me any alumni or guest lecture, guest faculty came ask for a Panasonic? Anyone remember? What's the name? I want that. Adesh, Mr. Adesh came from Panasonic. He's the HR. He told us that he shifted his focus from smartphone segment to IoT built homes. They shifted their smart electrical appliances they want to make.
Now moving on to the inappropriate import channels. So do you guys know what is SKD? Okay, so SKD is like, since they have an assembly unit here, they bring the products from Japan in semi knockdown stage. That is, the product is being parted into different parts and they are bringing it. What is the problem with semi knockdown stage is, like, they have high customs duty. If they have bought it in CKD, they would have less customs duty. This SKD also has another problem with logistics, because more vans or logistics is required for them. So the operational cost also went to the top. And you can see the less promotional activities. Varun Dhawan was appointed in the first as their brand ambassador in 2013. And as you can see, they have released only 5 advertisements in 5 years. That is very low. People like Vivo and Oppo, which came after them, like Panasonic came in 2013, and these people came in 2017, 15 or 16. And with the ads that they have, like Ranveer Singh and Amir Khan, they just went to the top. And they didn't opt for e-commerce also. They were believing that their hands-on experience can change the dynamic, and they thought they can have a distribution model which will help them in sales, but did not. E-commerce was the next big thing in that time, so they failed in that also.
This is the market share of smartphone users used in India. The first one topped by Xiaomi is 28%. The second one is Samsung, followed by Oppo, Vivo. Which 10% is Vivo, 8% Oppo, and Panasonic consists of only 0.33%. So the conclusion part, they didn't done any homework on Indian market. They didn't done any market research. What the pricing range we want, what the specification we want, what the design we want. That's why they launched P51 and LG launched P81. That is more technically advanced then. Thank you, sir. Thank you to listeners patiently. Lovely audience.